Well, that lens we can see on the house. That lens we can see worse. Blessed is our God, always, now, and forever, and the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you. Heavenly King, Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who are present everywhere and filling all things, the treasure of blessings and source of life, come, abide in us, cleanse us of all stain, and save our souls, O good one.
Thank you.
who are buried, and you renew me, the corrupted one.
He who with a seaweed and a tired Christian, one of them, the day of the week that I saw the place, that they live. Now as the Lord's day is dead, let us sing to the Lord, for he is greatly glorified. When creation beheld me, who without restraint suspended all the earth upon the waters, now suspended upon a cross on Golgotha. It was constrained by great astonishment, and cried aloud, no one is holy but you, O Lord.
Glory to you, our God, and glory to you. Of old, by many visions, you revealed the symbols of your burial. But what once kept secret, O Master, now, as God and man, you clearly show to those of me who cry aloud, no one is holy but you, O Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Savior, when you extended your hands, you united things that have been divided. By your confinement, and the shroud, and the sepulcher, you set free those who are fettered. To you they cry aloud, no one is holy but you, O Lord.
Look now at our speech, we come. You, on the temple, Master, were confined by the two seals of your own mouth. By your actions of God, O friend of man, you made your power known to all who cried aloud, no one is holy but you, O Lord.
When creation beheld you, who without restraint suspended all the earth upon the waters, now suspended on the cross upon Golgotha, it was constrained by great astonishment and cried aloud, no one is holy but you, O Lord.
The soldiers keep watching. My Savior, in the dead of the year of the red, and he claimed that you arose to the moment of the king of God. We still explore to your laws and presence. We worship you, our only God, who was there and rose from the Lord.
I think first of all, your God, and the Lord, and the Lord, and the Lord, and the Lord, to those of you and your
glory to you, our God, glory to you. Today you sanctified the Sabbath day, which you have blessed for, when you rested from your works. For you, O Savior, generate and renew all things, and while keeping the Sabbath, you will be made.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. When you, O Logos, were victorious through superior strength, your soul was separated from your body, and the shattered the bonds of both death and Hades by the power of your divinity.
Now, brethren, the nation did just promise. Hades was a bitter enemy, O Logos, seeing you, the Father, who bore the marks of bruises and yet was all powerful. At the fearful sight, was speechless and horrified. When he foresaw your divine and king, cry out of silence. He went to those in Hades and there cut off the heads of the wicked. O dear one and almighty God.
Prophet Isaiah once beheld the never setting light of your theophany, that is when you, O Christ our God, sympathetically appeared to us. Rising early in the morning, he cried aloud, the dead shall rise up, and those in the tombs shall rise, and all those on the earth shall be glad and give you joy.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you. Because you, with the fashioner, became a human being, you remake the earth for and the shroud and sepulcher, a word of God, and to make the mystery born in you. For Joseph, the respected member of the council, now performs the counsel of your father, who magnificently in you makes me king.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You change morality for death by means of burial, you change corruption for properly as God to make incorruptible and immortal that which you have assumed. For your body saw no corruption, likewise your soul was not abandoned in Hades, O Master, as you
remember. The name of the woman is spirit for the death, and the death spirit on the side. O my neighbor, from this side, you brought him to be fashioned. For becoming Adam, let us see, you imagine me in the life of this history, and then you raise up by yourself your slumber and from corruption as an almighty God.
Prophet Isaiah announced me how the heavens are light and clear. That is when you, Christ our God, see that include you in the spirit of bright and early in the morning, cry to God, doubt the dead shall rise up, and those in the tomb shall rise. All those in the earth shall be glad to their neighbors.
Let the foundation of the earth be shaken.
that we will exalt as we don't want to do, come to all the angels. Glory to you, our God, glory to you. The undefiled temple was destroyed. Then, with itself, it raised up the fallen tabernacle. The second Adam, who dwells in the heights, went down to the chambers of Hades in order to save the first man. Bless the Lord, the new servant. Sing to him, priests and people. Exalt him beyond measure unto all the ages.
We bless the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We sing a hymn to him and exalt him beyond measure unto the ages. Though the disciples' courage failed, yet that of Joseph of Arimathea was accepted. For when he sees that the God over all is hanging dead and naked, he asks for him and buries him in crime. Bless the Lord, O you servants. Sing a hymn, priests and people. Exalt him beyond all measure unto all the ages.
Now never into the ages of ages. O novel marvels that were wrong, O the benevolence, O the patience passing speech, for of his own love, he who dwells on the heights is sealed beneath the earth, and God is defended as a deceiver. Bless the Lord, O you servants, sing a hymn, priests and people, exalt him beyond measure into all the ages.
We praise and we bless and we worship the Lord. Heaven be astonished and amazed. And let the foundations of the earth be shaken. Behold, he who ever dwells in the heights of number among the dead, a small tomb receives him as a stranger. Bless the Lord, O you servants, singing him, priests and people, exalt him beyond measure to all the angels.
Thank you. given. And when you raise the dead from another world, all the hosts of heaven sang aloud to you, O Christ our God, giver of life, glory to you.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great love. We pray you hear us, and have mercy. Let us pray for pious and orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for our Archbishop and Father Nicholas.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for our brethren, the priests, the hieromonks, the hierodeacons, and the monastics, and all our brethren put in cross.
Lord, have mercy.
Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, protection, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servants of God, all pious and orthodox Christians residing and visiting in this city, the parishioners, the members of the parish council, the stewards and benefactors of this holy church.
Lord, have mercy, Lord.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy church and for all our fathers and brethren who have fallen asleep before us, who here have been piously laid their rest, as well as the Orthodox everywhere.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bear fruit and do good works in this holy and all venerable church, for those who labor and those who sing, and for the people here present who await your great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For your merciful God, bless them, God, and we will offer up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Holy Father, bless.
May he who is risen from the dead, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all pure and all immaculate Holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and foreigner John the Baptist, of the holy, glorious and praiseworthy apostles, of the holy, glorious and triumphant martyrs, of our righteous and God-bearing fathers, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and merciful and loves mankind.
Amen.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.